Hey friends, today we're making a best bite recipe from the Dr. Seuss Baking Challenge, and it's a chocolate hazelnut rocher. It's gonna be so delicious. Watch the Dr. Seuss Baking Challenge now on Prime Video. You guys, this is the easiest recipe ever. We're literally gonna just take all of our ingredients, put them in the mixer until they're fully incorporated, and then we're pretty much done. Hazelnuts first.
So wait, you're doing like a recipe that was a winner from the show?
Yes, so they're called Best Bites. And every episode, out of all the treats we tasted, we picked one that we thought was the most amazing, and that's the one that goes in the Dr. Seuss Baking Challenge store, and it's free. Salt, chocolate hazelnut paste. By the way, this recipe calls for hazelnut paste, which can be a little hard to find. So if you can't find it, you can always use some other kind of butter, like peanut butter. This is actually cookie butter.
I don't think I've ever had a rocher before.
It's rocher.
But it's spelled rocher, right?
It's spelled rocher, yes, I'll give you that. Melted chocolate. Now we mix on low until incorporated. Oh my God, it smells so good. Give it a little scrapey scrape.
I really like your mix A. Oh, sorry, that's mixer pronounced like Rocher.
Like Ferrero Rocher.
Yeah, that's how you say it.
That's such a hard word to say. All right. What Ashley and Rebecca did to finalize this was they took an ice cream scoop and scooped some of the mixture out onto a Silpat, like this. Put it in the freezer and then dipped it in chocolate, topped it with hazelnut and salt. So we're gonna do one like that, but I gotta put my spin on it. I'm gonna make a tart. By the way, Rebecca and Ashley were the recipe dream team. I don't think they made anything that I didn't like. They were so good at flavors. All right, I got a tart shell here.
They were like the cooking version of me and Brandon, huh?
Sure. Oh, you mean for production? Yeah, of course.
I meant friendship.
And that too.
You guys mean everything to me.
Shut up, Joshua.
Brothers, hey, no, you're not, that's my line. Shut up, James.
I could eat this rocher just like this, honestly.
You could eat this right out of here for sure, but you want to get it to set up so it has like, the chocolate will sort of be the binder. We're gonna cover this in chocolate as well, and then when we cut it, it's gonna be like a piece of candy bar. Like really elevated French candy bar. Is that enough? I feel like I wanna put some more. That little bit is what I needed. Look, it looks like a face. We're gonna get these into the freezer, get them firm, and then we're gonna dip them in chocolate. Let's go, buddy. What should we name them?
Let's name him Roger.
Oh no. Rocher.
Ah, I see what you did there.
Everything's firmed up. I got my melted chocolate and all of my toppings. So this is gonna be kind of messy, but it's really fun. Bloop.
Can I do the next one?
Yeah. By the way, yes, I do have a gold for it. Okay, James.
Oh my God, my children wear cardboard boxes.
Oh, I need this.
Okay. Joshua's Kitchen was sponsored by Captain Jack Sparrow. And all the stolen treasure.
Do you really want to pop this in?
Can I do it from here? From downtown?
Yeah, here.
From downtown!
You're overthinking
it. Do I just dunk it?
Just drop it.
Is it a gentle?
Just drop it in there.
Okay.
Oh my God, not from that high. Look what you did.
Made well, just mess. Use your gold cutlery to get it out.
Oh man, see Brandon?
Oh my gosh, Joshua. Did you see the clock?
What?
It's time for
Dr. Seuss Trivia.
All right, so the challenge today, how many words does the book Green Eggs and Ham contain? How many total different words are in Green Eggs and Ham?
You want me to go first?
Including the repeat words? Like they say egg a lot.
Not including repeat words.
Not, so just words, all the words?
Yes.
Well, his books are pretty short, right? So I'm gonna say 107.
Brandon, any guesses?
No idea how I came up with that.
4,000.
No way, dude. That's like the Bible.
The vocabulary of the text consists of just 50 words.
Oh, well, I was closer.
And was the result of a bet between Seuss and Bennett Cerf, Dr. Seuss's publisher.
Look at that.
I think just reading books would help me.
You should start with Dr. Seuss. They're pretty easy. So when you dip them, you want to make sure that you put your toppings on before it sets up so everything sticks. But that's the best bite there. Now I'm going to cover the tart that I made. This I'm just gonna pour on.
Can I pour that on?
No. You've been fired. You have that job. You're good at that job. I'm gonna use my little spatula here. Cover all of our rocher mix. So So before it sets, we're gonna put our toppings on. So we're gonna do a little bit of sea salt. We're going to do some hazelnuts. And because I'm me, we're gonna do... No, sprinkles!
Okay.
Actually, Susie color sprinkles.
Like the doctor.
My doctor actually is named Dr. Seuss. It's so awkward. Y'all, this dessert looks super fancy and it was so easy to make. If you want this recipe, you can find it in the Dr. Seuss Baking Challenge store on Amazon. Be sure to subscribe to us, hit the notification bell. I'm Joshua John Russell and you've been deserted. Let's cut this baby.
It tastes expensive.